This is the one to use actually in our project. I already have this diva beta APK file. If that's the case, it should be really, really carefully done. Hey guys, and welcome to a new episode of Nomadic Dmitry channel. Today we're going to talk about penetration testing. And for penetration testing, we're going to discuss the framework which is called mobsf. This is the GitHub page of this project, and you can basically learn more about the project right here. But today we're just gonna basically like go through it like very, very fast and just discuss how it works. The main goal of mobsf framework is basically to analyze the application and to understand the areas of the application that needs to be improved. In this case, it's used for Android penetration testing. And today we're going to discuss specifically the diva application for Android. This application was intentionally made very, very vulnerable with a bunch of errors and bunch of mistakes in the code. Very, very unsecure application. And this mobsf framework is a perfect way to understand how it's possible to analyze the application like that. So it's not necessary you can use this application. You can use any other application in your testing. For example, we just opened one of those sections and just discusses what are the hard-coded strings and how bad the hard-coded strings are. Different kind of issues you can see in the application, like in the UI itself. It's intentionally made for you to be able to analyze this kind of problems and to find those. So what we actually need to have in order to test our application for the vulnerability issues? The first thing we need to have is a Docker. Docker is just a perfect way of running this application because it has a bunch of different components, and you can just download it separately, download all those files separately and just run from the terminal. But Docker is like a better, more simple way to do all that, in my opinion at least. So I already have Docker installed, and what we need to do, we actually need to pull this image, this specific image. Let me actually show you what I mean. When we type Docker image, so it shows images that we have, and here's this framework that we need. I have the other framework I downloaded, which is basically something different, like a clone of mobsf or something like that, but don't use this one. This is the one to use actually in our project. So we're gonna just copy this one right here, paste it. So it's basically just going to download the instance of this Docker image. I already have this image, so it's nothing to download here. All right, so we have it on our local machine. And the next step to do is basically this one. This is actually the command to run all that, just to execute the Docker image. We also specify the ports right here. So once we do that, it's just going to start this Docker image on a specific port. And actually going to show us which port it's running. So this is like, we need to just copy this one. All right, so we copy it from here. And we're just gonna open it in Safari, and here it is. So we have it running on our local host, and we're all ready to perform our testing, penetration testing. We need to actually drag and drop our APK file. I already have this diva beta APK file downloaded. It's right here actually. I'm gonna provide it down in the description below. You just need to unzip it, and the APK file, just drag and drop it right here, and it's gonna provide our all the information about this application right now. It just takes some time to analyze. All right, so here we go. What do we have here actually? Just interesting to know. Here's the app information, package name, activity, target SDK, minimum SDK, maximum SDK. So it has 17 activities. And you know guys, the activities in terms of Android is basically like a pages of application. How many pages of application does it have? So it just lists all those here. Providers, files, just basically list all the files which are in this package. And here, the manifest analysis, when we look at there, we see bunch of issues here. So activity, it says activity found to be shared with other apps on the device. So this is bad. So manifest file, guys, if you don't know, this is just basically the configuration of the whole package for the Android, or the whole Android package, and it just lists all the things that this application can perform. For example, is it allowed to grab information from the internet? Is it allowed to access external media? Is it allowed to do this or that? Basically all configured the manifest file. Content provider. Content provider is a very powerful tool, and it allows to basically share information from one application to the other. If it's done incorrectly, it basically exposes a bunch of problems. In this case, it says, yeah, severity is high, so this is bad. So then debug enabled for the app. The debug mode in Android, this is basically the way to see all the information, all the login activity of the application. For the production app, the amount of logs should be really, really limited, really small. And in this case, something is wrong here. App can read and write to external storage. So as you can see, this is bad. There might no such need to do that, like this kind of access, but the app just requests it and we don't know what it does. App creates temp file sensitive information. Again, this app seems to have working with some sensitive user information. For example, in some cases I saw that it works with the credit card data or something, asks you to enter the credit card information. Like for example, of course it's not real credit card information, but just like for the testing purposes. But in this case it's really bad. It should not be exposed like that. Another problem here is, for example, this one. It says app uses SQLite database and execute raw SQL query. So we should be always very cautious about those kind of things. If that's the case, it should be really, really carefully done. The app logs information, sensitive information should never be logged. And I think this is actually one of the problems. For example, here it says insecure login. Yeah, it says entering credit card information, and I think when you enter it, it just logs it all out. So this is bad. This is just all just based on manifest, and there are probably some other issues that is detected. Just take a look at those all those things. But yeah, content providers and manifest file are like basically two things that you should definitely check. And it says overall score, for example, here's a 55 out of 100. This is not exactly the real picture. I think this is even like much more insecure than it's shown here, but still it just allows you to basically understand the general idea, like of just a few seconds, just to understand what this app is doing and what's performing, what kind of action it's doing. And you can also like press to save it as a PDF and print this report, just like to show to your PM or manager, just like discuss the vulnerabilities in your app and stuff like that. I think it's really great way to like just go through this information and understand what's good and what's bad. For example, here it says again permissions, says internet access, and it says dangerous. Yeah, exactly, like if application is accessing the internet, like we should be actually having a reason why it's accessing internet, right? And here it has read and write storage permissions, so like so dangerous. All right guys, so this was a very short overview of Android penetration testing tool, which is called MobSF, and I hope you like this episode. And if you like this video, please subscribe for more. There'll be more videos about the penetration testing, about the testing, and I'm also doing lots of operating system reviews. I really like this kind of genre. If you like it too, please consider subscribing for more videos and just go check it out, the existing videos. Thank you very much and see you soon.